I have another haul. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I am Alicia Danelle, and thank you all so much for coming back for another video. As you can see, I am pumping these videos out, trying to get my channel to get these numbers to go up, these subscribers, these views, all that stuff to go up. So I'm pumping these videos out like crazy. So I have another haul. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. Don't you judge me. I have another haul. This is the Black Friday and my Sephora VIB sale. I know I still have to record my part two to the haul that I did before. If you all did not see that video, I will link that video down below. But I told y'all in that video that I had three parts. I still got to do my part two. Part three is already recorded, like I told y'all. So hold on, I'm coming. So I got all of my stuff in for Black Friday, y'all. Yes, I just got my package from Sephora for Black Friday in today. So I was like, let me just go ahead and record this video. So I would go ahead and get started, because y'all, I still gotta go to work, but I was like, I'm gonna get this video out though first. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna show y'all everything that I got for the Sephora VIB as well as Black Friday, but I'm gonna show you all my Sephora VIB sale first. So if you don't know anything about Sephora, the VIB sale, twice a year Sephora has a sale for their insider group, and it's three different levels you could be. You could be just an insider, which you get 15%, VIB you get 15%, and if you are like me and you spend too much money at Sephora, you are Rouge and you get 20%. So I did take part in that sale. So I'm gonna show y'all everything that I got from that sale. I did show y'all some of this stuff in my other haul. I do believe I showed y'all some of this stuff in my other haul. I know for sure I showed y'all this palette right here. So I'm just gonna quickly show y'all this one really fast. I did show y'all this palette right here. I know for sure I did. Right here, I'll just show you that really quickly. This is the Huda Beauty Naughty Nudes. So I did show y'all them. Like I said, I showed y'all this in my first part of my haul, the eyeshadow palettes and stuff. So I just wanted to quickly show y'all that. I think I did show you all these two palettes too. I'm pretty sure I did, these two palettes right here. And the top one is the Mini Metropolis, and the bottom one is the Mini Sunset palette. Like I said, I'm pretty sure I did show y'all that. So I'm gonna go ahead and just quickly show it to you all first. And get that out the way, and then that's that one right there. Okay, so okay, so the next thing that I got during the VIB sale, I did go ahead and get the Fenty Beauty Mocha Mommy. Dang, I feel like I showed y'all this too, but whatever. I don't think I did, but anyways, the Fenty Beauty Mocha Mommy bronzer. I do have not Mocha Mommy, Coco Natty. I'm sorry, I do have the Mocha Mommy. See, this is why I'm thinking that I showed y'all this in that video too. So I'm just gonna go ahead and really show y'all that really quickly. I just can't remember really, but that's that right there. I bought this because sometimes I don't always want to be dark like the Mocha Mommy. Sometimes I just want a soft brown, so I bought this one for that purpose. Okay, so I did pick up the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Skin Powder Foundation. I wanted a different powder foundation, so I did pick this up. I picked this up in the color Y505, and then there is that back right there. I love this foundation. I'm in love with it. I love it a lot, and that's what that looks like right there. It do come with a little puff thingy. As y'all can see, I have used this foundation a couple of times, and I really do like it. I really do. My favorite is the MAC. The MAC Studio Fix Powder. That's my favorite. But I'm starting to like this one too. So I don't know. And so the next thing I picked up from that sale was, and some of this stuff is out of the box because I've already been using this stuff. So because my box took so long to come, which made this video for the VIB part of it a little old, I should say, because the sale been off. So, but nevertheless, it's here. But I did get the NARS Radiant Creamy Color Corrector in the color medium. I think it's medium deep. Medium deep. I'm trying to wipe it off because it's a little dirty because I've been wearing it. And that's that product right here. This is like a color corrector. I like this. I really do. I really like it. However, I've never used a color corrector before. So that's what the color looks like. So the jury's still out on it, because I'm not sure if I'm using it the proper way that I'm supposed to use it. So I do like it though. I do like it. It does cover some of the stuff, but again, I don't really have, you know, like discoloration or anything like that on my face. Only thing that I do like it for is my lids, because my lids are a little bit dark because I don't get sleep, I guess. But that's really all I use it for. So the jury's still out on it. I'm not sure how it's going to look right now. And then the other thing that I got from Sephora was the Bobbi Brown Bronze Gold Highlight. And that's that right there. I decided to buy this on the VIB sale because, again, I didn't want to just be buying something just to be buying something. I wanted to make sure that I was getting something that I actually really wanted. And I did get this. I had been really wanting this. Here's that, what that looked like right there. I have been really wanting this this highlight ever since it came out years ago when it was just a limited edition bronzer, but I didn't get it then. So now I got it, and I don't really like it that much. Let me swatch it so y'all can see. I'm not really a big fan of it, but I'm gonna keep it. It's on this hand right here, and keep working with it and see. Oh, I do like that swatch though. But that's it right there. Right there. That's it right there. I kind of like it now that I swatched it on there. Jeez. Okay. Lord. But nevertheless, we're still working on it. We're still working on it. So, yeah. So, I did also purchase some things from Makeup Mario. Makeup by Mario. I seen a couple of girls on here using his bronzer and his concealer sticks, so I want to try it out. So I did get the, oh my goodness, this stuff is so dirty from me using it. I'm so sorry. But anyways, this is the Makeup by Mario concealer stick in the color deep or dark deep, and that's what this product looks like right here. Let me turn it around this way. There we go. That's what that product looks like right there. And then this is what the color is. Hold up, let me try to. That's what the color is looking like right there. Really dark. There it goes. Right there. I do like this product. However, this product is really, really hard to blend out. It is like, once you put it in place, it's like, it ain't moving. I mean, it is. I was going to get out of, hold on. It is really hard to blend out. So here is it blended out. And of course, it was going to blend out good. Of course, but when I put it on my face, it seemed so hard to blend out. So I used it probably once or twice, and I was like, okay, this is too much. I can't, you know, I can't get this product to move properly. So I'm still working on how to make sure this, make this product moved a little bit. Okay. So I also got the powder bronzer in the color deep, and that is this. Oh my god, this stuff is so dirty. Maybe I should have probably looked at the dirt, looked at the product before I started the video. But nevertheless, here it is. This is a product right here. Now this right here, I love this. This, I love this bronzer. Here's what that bronzer look. Oops, sorry y'all. Here's what that bronzer look like. I really love this bronzer. Oh my god, I love this bronzer. Did I put it on today? I think I put it on today. I can't remember, but I'm in love with this one. It blends beautifully. It goes on and it blends beautifully. I love it. So, yeah. And then I also bought the Makeup by Mario blush in the color Poppy Pink. Now, y'all, here is this right here. Now, y'all, excuse me. this blush is bomb. Oh my god, this blush is so bomb. This blush is super duper duper pigmented. I did put it on today. Yo, let me swatch it. Yo, this, look at that, look at that. This stuff is amazing. I wanted to get another one, and I thought I did buy another one. That's it right there, on my arm right there. I wanted to buy another one, and I thought I did buy another one, but for some reason when my order came, it wasn't in there. I could have swore I bought another one for Black Friday, but my order wasn't in there, so I don't know what happened with that. But nevertheless, the last things that I bought from the Sephora VIB sale was the Pat McGrath concealer in the color M20. And that's what that concealer looked like right there. I did get another color, but it's too dark, and it is in my purse because I went to Sephora to switch it out and I forgot to bring it here in the room. But they couldn't switch it out anyways because they didn't sell Pat McGrath at that location that I was at. So nevertheless, whatever. Anyways, here is what that concealer looks like. The color of that concealer looks like right there. I really like this concealer too. I really do. I like this concealer too. I want to get a different color to do like contouring a little bit and see how it works for that. So I like this one too. And then I bought the Pat McGrath Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation. Y'all, this foundation is not full coverage. It is, I think, medium coverage. But this foundation, oh my god, I am in love with this foundation. This foundation, it looks literally like you airbrush this foundation on your face. It's really watery, really thin, but when you put it on and you build it up, it makes your face look like you just used airbrush or something. You just like brush this stuff on. That's how good this foundation is. It is amazing. It is expensive. It's all outdoors, but if it's a sale, get it. Unless your pockets is thick and you could get it without it. I don't know, but mine's ain't, so I did it on a sale. So but this, oh my god, this foundation is so good. So good. And I was so proud of myself because I actually I'm sorry, I didn't tell you how the color I got. Medium deep. I actually picked my color out on the internet, and I kind of just went and looked and seen it, and I ended up getting my perfect color. I love this one. I love it. Love it. So that is all I got on the Sephora VIB sale. Granted, I did do two orders of the Sephora VIB sale, but yeah, that's all I got. So don't ask me. I don't know. But anyways, I feel like I'm missing something. I do feel like I'm missing something, though. I don't know what it is. I really feel like I'm missing something. But nevertheless, I'm just going to keep going because I got to get out of here. Anyways, so the stuff that I bought for Black Friday. Now, Black Friday, same thing I did with Sephora. I ordered stuff twice. Yeah, I ordered stuff twice or three times. It was twice. I can't remember. But anyways, I did the same thing with Black Friday. I ordered stuff a couple of times. So I do have some of the stuff in this box right here. And then some of the stuff is in this bag right here because I had to pick some of the stuff up in the store and exchange some things. So that's the reason why I have a bag and a box. So nevertheless, let's go. So the first thing I got was the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna Glossy Posse Fantasy Foursome, and that is it right here. It comes with four different glosses. I should have took them out. Okay. Excuse me. Okay, y'all, sorry about that. That took some doing to get these glosses out. Okay, so anyways, let me see if I can see the color again, y'all. Here I am again with no glasses trying to read stuff. Y'all know the deal. So anyways, this color, wait, let me see if they got it on the box, because I ain't gonna read that, y'all. So I'd rather read it off the box. Okay, this one is Candy Milk right here. Here's Candy Milk right there. These are my very first Fenty Beauty glosses. I don't have nothing from Fenty Beauty gloss wise. And that's what the color looks like right there. Let's see. Wait, let me put on this hand because this hand is filled up and stuff. That's what that looks like. That's pretty. I like that. That's really pretty. I really love that. And then this color is called the Fenty Glow Fantasy. Is that the right one? Let me make sure. Yeah. This one is the Fenty Glow Fantasy right here. That's pretty. This look like a kind of like an iridescent color. Let's see. Can I get it open? And then there is what that color looks like. There we go. Color looks like. And then let me swatch that one on the back of my arm. So you all can see that one. I like this one a lot. And then that is that one right there. Really pretty. And this one is called Champ Stamp Fantasy. And that's what that one looks like right there. And I am going to be doing a lip. The part two is my lips. But I just went on ahead and showed y'all these ones. I could have just saved them, but I just went on ahead and showed y'all these ones. Hopefully I remember that when I get ready to film my other one. I don't know. This one is kind of clear, so you ain't gonna be able to see it that well. Let me swatch it. This one is like a clear with some sparkles in it. It's pretty. I really like that one. And that's what that one is looking like right there. And then lastly, we have the Hot Chocolate Fantasy. Is that what I say? Hot Chocolate. Wait. Yeah, okay. I just want to make sure I didn't mix these things up. And that's what that one looks like right there. This one is another iridescent. This one reminds me of the MAC pigment that's like the brown and green specks in it a little bit. And that's that one right there. Let me swatch it so y'all can see. And that's that one. Those are pretty. I really like those. And I got the mini. I mean, you know, these little mini ones, it's fine for me because, again, I don't wear makeup that often. And you'll see in my lip haul that I got enough. And these little ones will be just fine. So, I did get those for Black Friday. And then for Black Friday, I also bought this eyelash clincher, and I got it because I want to be able to clench my. Did y'all just see that? What was it? Oh my god! I got it so I could make sure my eyelashes are down good. When I put them on, that's the reason why I bought this. I seen somebody on YouTube, which is so bad, because when you go on YouTube, they really will make you spend your money every time. Well, I should say they'll make me spend my money, but I really loved when she used it. I was like, oh, I need that, because sometimes I don't feel like my lashes is all the way together. So they give you like a separate, or a I don't want to say separate, what do you call it, an extra little clench thing. I guess that's extra anyways. And then here is this product right here. And like I said, I wanted it so I can get them eyebrows together. Okay. So yeah. And then the next thing that I got was another Natasha Denona palette. Well, the mini Natasha Denona palettes. And this one was from the Mini Love. This was the Mini Love one. I wanted the Love palette, the full size one, because it was 50% off. And I just, every time I went on there, it was sold out and I couldn't get it, and I was so mad. So I just was like, forget it, just give me the little mini thing. So that was what that looked like right there. You see that right there. And then here is what that one looks like right there. There we go. That's what that one looks like right there. I really wanted to look the full size, but whatever. They ain't gonna get to me. It's all good. Okay, so the next thing I got.
Did I get this?
Yes. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot to show y'all something. I did get the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Foundation. Stays all day and night. And I got the color 12.5 natural. And this is another thing that I took back to Sephora to make sure that I had picked the right color. And I actually did, which I was happy about. But this is what that foundation looked like right there. Usually when I get my foundations offline, every time I get my foundations offline, it don't be the right color every time. So I was really excited that I was able to get the right color. That foundation right there. I haven't tried this foundation yet, but I seen it on YouTube, so I know I'm gonna love it, so I'm not even concerned about that. And then I also got the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray, and that's this product right here. This is the mini size. I'm mad, y'all, because I really wanted the full size, but whatever, I got the mini size. And then here is that product. Now, I've heard so many good things about this spray. So, I'm really excited to try this spray. I really am excited. So, yeah. And then the last thing I got in the box, anyways, is the Urban Decay Naked 3 palette. It's right here. Now, when this palette first came out, I did not want this palette. I was like, nah, I don't want it. It's not colors that I really want. But when it was 50% off, I was like, well, I'll take it. If it's 50% off, I'll take it. And then, because, like, you know, I started this whole little Urban Decay collection situation, and the 2 and the 3 is one of the ones that I don't have. The 2 is discontinued, so I probably won't never be getting that palette. But I did look up and get the 3, so that's what that palette looks like. And then here is, let me take this brush out. It does, y'all, come with a brush, as you know. And then here is what those colors look like. Those colors, again, like I said, those colors don't scream me at all. It doesn't look like colors that I would, you know, gravitate to. But it's 50% off, so yeah. So those are the things that I got. Well, the first part of what I got for the Black Friday sale, and then the rest of them is in here. Now, it's one thing in here that I got during the Sephora VIB sale, and I had to take it back to get another color. Let me show y'all that really quickly. That was the NARS Soft Matte Complete Foundation. That's this one right here. Y'all, I've been wanting this foundation for so long. And I just kept putting off. So then when the VIB sale came, I was like, okay, fine. Even though I got 2 other foundations sitting over here and 1 in this bag. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, whatever. Here it goes. Whatever. Here it goes. Ooh, y'all. I tried to go on a no-buy. I really did. But that no-buy did not last long. Okay? And I got the color medium deep 4 in this foundation. I hope I'm gonna like this foundation. I hope. I was gonna show y'all a swatch, but I don't really want to get it dirty, so never mind. Sorry. But I bought that during the VIB sale. I just took it back to get my color, the correct color, anyways, on Black Friday, which is how I ended up with this stuff that's in this bag right here. So let's go. So, the first thing I got was the Sephora, what brush is this? 50 Pro Brush, Pro Powder Brush, and that is that right there. Um, I've been holding on this stuff. I haven't keeping it in the box. Alright, y'all. I literally had to, like, literally cut this thing up to get this off. Man. But anyways, here is that brush right here. Oh my god. This brush is so soft. I cannot wait to use this brush. This brush is so soft. I don't have any Sephora brand brushes, but I've seen them perform on YouTube when I watch makeup tutorials. And I don't know how this is my first one, because I love me some brushes. Oh my god. I love me some eyeshadow palettes, some blush, highlighter, and brushes. So yeah, I don't know how. I don't know. But whatever. I don't know. I got it now. That's all that matters. And then I decided to take the plunge and go with the hype that everybody is talking about. And that is the Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Primer. Man, I done heard all kinds of good stuff about this primer. So I just decided to go ahead and get it and try it. Now, I have Milk's foundation and I hate it. I hate it. And again, I was going off the hype that everybody was talking about with that foundation, and that I hate that foundation. I swear I do. I really do hate it. So I'm hoping that here is what this product looks like. I'm really hoping that Lord have mercy. I'm really hoping that I don't hate this this primer. Y'all know I'm really not big on primer. I really don't have to prime. A lot of times I forget to do it. So we're gonna see. It's just like a gel consistency, I guess. So yeah, it's just like a gel consistency. Y'all probably never gonna see that. But we're gonna see. I did like the one that Elf used to have of like this. But I haven't used it in so long, but we're gonna see. So then I just went on ahead and bought my Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. I just bought it in the full size. I do have it in the mini, and I started using it recently, and I figured I was gonna buy the full size, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fill up my mini whenever I travel, so that way I'm not having to take this big old thing. So at least that's how I'm gonna justify my purchase anyways. So I did get that. I do want to get the one in banana, but yeah, I'm not gonna do that right now. So yeah. So I got my favorite foundation of all time. This is absolutely, positively, for sure my favorite. My second favorite is the MAC Studio Fix foundation. But okay, y'all, my camera turned off and I didn't even know. So I was talking about this Makeup Forever foundation. It's the Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation. I love this foundation so much. I really do. I've been using this foundation since I started wearing makeup, okay? Well, wearing makeup seriously. So anyways, here is that foundation right here. I think this was my very first high-end foundation purchase, and I've been buying it ever since. But the only problem with this is she gave me the wrong color. She gave me Y508, and I needed the other one, Y468, I think, or something like that. So I have to take this back because it is not my color, but that is what it looks like. Let me turn it around so y'all can see. I don't really want to open up. This one is a little bit too dark, but the other one was perfect. So I do have to take this back. Whenever that'll be, I do not know. So I'm gonna put that back in the box. And then I also picked up the Makeup Forever Ultra HD concealer, and that one is in the color 4.5, and that's what that concealer looks like. And then this is what that concealer looks like right there. I did get a brighter color because I wanted to highlight with it, so that's the reason why it's so light, because I wanted to highlight with it. Let's find a place where I can swatch this so you can see. It's not as bright as y'all think it is. The way it looks, it's there. That's that right there. That right there. So that's the reason why I got it so bright, because I wanted to highlight with it. Yeah. Okay. So the last thing that I got from the Black Friday, from Black Friday sale, was another Natasha Denona palette, and this was the Natasha Denona bronze palette right here. I wanted the gold palette, but I can't find it, or I don't know if she discontinued it or what. So I just went on ahead and got this one, and then that is what the palette itself looks like. And then, come on, these are the smaller palettes, so these palettes cost less than the bigger ones. So here is this palette right there. This is really pretty, and I'm wondering if she changed the gold to bronze instead, named bronze instead. I don't know, but nevertheless, that's that palette right there. Last thing I needed was a palette, but I love palettes, so it is what it is. Okay, y'all, so that is everything that I got from the Sephora VIB sale, along with my stuff that I got for Black Friday. Make sure you all subscribe to my YouTube channel. More videos are coming, y'all, so I'm pumping them out. So make sure you all subscribe and make sure you turn on your notifications. I will link my haul that I just did recently down below. If you have not checked that out, I will put that down in the description box. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, y'all.